Dear students, now in this video we are going to see the next heat treatment process, that is the tempering. So as we seen, dear students, the product of the hardening process is the martensite, because we are rapidly cooling the austenite directly to the room temperature, creating the martensitic structure, which is not directly applicable, isn't it? So to have that use of that martensite in this application, basically we have to again go for subsequent heat treatment process, and actually this tempering is one of these. Because see, this tempering is immediately followed after the hardening process. So we can see that the tempering actually is the secondary heating. Tempering is secondary heating of martensite. And how this martensite has formed? So secondary heating of martensite, which is obtained, how? Which is obtained by rapid cooling of the austenite. That is gamma austenite, isn't it? So now this tempering is the process of secondary heating of the martensite, which is obtained by the rapid cooling of martensite. And see, if I show you here, this is our lower critical temperature, 723 degree centigrade, and above this everything is what? The gamma. Actually this was our initial sample, and we heated it to the austenitic range, and after, when we cool this austenite to the room temperature or in the water bath, salt bath, oil bath, we are getting this needle like structure, isn't it? We get this needle like structure, which is nothing but what? The martensite. This is the martensite. And martensite is, you know very well, it is very hard and brittle. It cannot be directly used for the application. So now we are again to enhance some properties. Which properties? The first property, very important, that we are going to relieve the internal residual stresses, or the stresses, internal stresses, or the strains because of this hardening. Whichever the these hardening strains are there, internal residual stresses are there, we want to remove from this martensite, isn't it? Then of course, to increase or to restore the ductility, or you can say to restore again the softness in the steel. Next, to have the machinability in the steel. So very importantly, the tempering that we are doing is for removing the internal stresses, to increasing the ductility, or to and have the softness in the steel, and also to get the sufficient strength. Also we can heat this secondary product of this austenite, isn't it? That is martensite. Now see, here there are temperature range to which we can heat this martensite. Say from, this is 100 degree centigrade, this is 200 degree centigrade, and this is, say I am taking as, this is 500 degree centigrade. Of course this is 400 degree centigrade, isn't it? So based upon the various temperature range, so in which temperature you are heating this martensite, so the tempering process are classified into three types. Kon se type say? Number one, that is low temperature tempering. Low temperature tempering. The second one is medium temperature tempering, and the third is high temperature tempering. High temperature tempering. So if you see this low temperature tempering, it is heating the martensite in the range of 100 to 200 degree centigrade. Medium temperature tempering from 200 degree centigrade to 500 degree centigrade, and high temperature tempering is from 500 degree centigrade to below this lower critical temperature, that is 700 degree centigrade. So these are three tempering processes we are having. So what is happening in the first tempering? I am drawing this diagram here. See, I am having here this low temperature tempering, what we are going to get here, then this tempering in this range of say from 500 degree centigrade to the 700 degree centigrade, how we can get here. So see here, the products that we are going to get after heating of this martensite, so this is actually known as the trucite. This is the sorbite and this is the spheroidite. Okay, so dear students, so these are actually the product of the heating of the martensite, that is trucite, sorbite and spheroidite. So let us see the first, that is a low temperature tempering. So see, when we heat this martensite up to the range of say 100 to 200 degree centigrade, so here the martensite is going to decompose into low carbon martensite and the transition carbide. The transition carbide. Okay, so only what thing is going to happen at low temperature tempering? This martensite is going to decompose into the low carbon martensite plus this transition carbide. So this low carbon martensite, dear student, please remember, this is known as the tempered martensite. Kya bolte isko? This low carbon martensite is known as the tempered martensite, whereas this transition carbide is known as the epsilon carbide. What is our carbide? Fe3C. But this epsilon carbide is nothing but Fe2.4C. Please remember, this is the epsilon carbide. So what will happen in the low temperature tempering? Only this martensite is going to decompose to form this tempered martensite and this epsilon carbide. That is this low temperature tempering. Now, when we heat this martensite in the range of from 200 degree centigrade to 500 degree centigrade, there will be the cementite formation takes place. And we can see very fine distribution of the cementite particles in this matrix of ferrite, we can see. So see here, these are in the matrix of ferrite, we are having very fine distribution of the cementite particles. And see, this structure is actually known as the trucite. So this is the medium temperature tempering I am talking about, the heating the martensite in the range of 200 to 500 degree centigrade, that will form the cementites, and these are finely distributed particles in the matrix of ferrite, isn't it? Ferrite is the alpha iron. So in that matrix we are having the small distribution of these particles known as the cementite, and the structure actually given by Sir L.J. Troost. Kisne diya tha ye? L.J. Troost. He was a French scientist, and in his honor this structure is known as the trucite, isn't it? So this is happening from the temperature range to 200 to 500 degree centigrade. And dear students, from the temperature from the temperature 500 degree centigrade to this 700 degree centigrade or below just lower critical temperature, this cementite particles, So what this happened? You can see these cementite particles are become coarser. They become coarse. The cementite which was fine in the true site, now the cementite become coarse, isn't it? And if we just resolve these particles under the optical microscope, we will see they are looking like the spheroidal in shape. They are spheroidal in shape. So that is the reason this, the microstructure you can see here, the cementite, it is coarser in structure, it is coarse. And if you see under the optical, you resolve it under micro optical microscope, you will see the spheroidal shape of these cementite particles. And that is the name, this structure is named as the spheroidite. Okay, so here the structure you can see in the form of spherical globules, definitely which can increase the machinability of high carbon steels. So see, this is the cementite you can see here in the coarse form, but when this cementite is sufficiently in the fine size and you cannot able to resolve under the optical microscope, this they will be look like this. Okay, and this structure actually, when the cementite is sufficiently fine and we cannot resolve under the optical microscope, so this is known as the sorbite. Okay, so they are very nearer structures. Okay, here the cementite is much coarser than this. Here is the cementite which is present in the ferrite matrix, is coarser, but here it will take the spherical or the globule form, isn't it? It like a cementite in the form of spherical globules. So this is known as the spheroidite. So, and of course this is going to give us very good machinability in the high carbon steels. So again there is a heat treatment process is named as the spheroidizing. We are covering it into the annealing process, isn't it? So this is about see the tempering. Tempering is nothing but the secondary heating of the martensite obtained by the rapid cooling of the austenite. We will get this three temperature range, 100 to 200, 200 to 500, 500 to 700. We are getting the structures like trucite, sorbite and spheroidite. If you look look here, only the changes in this cementite particle sizes, rest of the structure mein kya hai? जो हमने शुरुआत से देखा था जब हम हीट करते हैं मार्टेनसाइट, तो सो देयर इज ऑलवेज द लो कार्बन मार्टेनसाइट इज देयर व्हिच इज टेम्पर्ड मार्टेनसाइट. सो देयर इज नो एनी स्ट्रक्चरल चेंज. प्लीज हियर, ओनली द सीमेंटाइट साइज, सीमेंटाइट पार्टिकल साइज समवेयर फाइनर एंड समवेयर कोर्सर. रेस्ट ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर जो है वो क्या है? एज इट इज टेम्पर्ड मार्टेनसाइट. प्लीज रिमेंबर दिस. सो डियर स्टूडेंट, सो दिस इज द tempering process. Thank you.